My name is Susan Clarke, and I'm an industry strategy manager at Autodesk, focused on our expansion into building operations. I'm excited to be joined by Nick today from Eptura. Please introduce yourself and your role at Eptura.
Sure. Name's Nick Stefanidakis, and I head up our strategic alliances at Eptura. And as Susan mentioned, I'm very excited about the opportunity to work together and to build this great technology for managing buildings and space in the future.
Last year, Autodesk and Eptura announced that we're going to formally work together to create a next generation platform that can manage building lifecycle data. Nick, can you tell us more about this alliance and what it means for customers?
Yeah, I'm very excited about it because I have been involved with this initiative to form this alliance with Autodesk since the conversation started. And to get from where we started to where we are today, it's just been a great journey. And I think from the beginning, the vision was, just as you described, to connect the workflows from design and construction into operations. And that can mean maintenance and assets, but also what we were talking about, workplace and how people use the space and are productive in the space. And then even closing the loop on that, bringing the data that is collected and measured and managed during operations and feed that back into the next project, the next planning and design construction process. So I think the value proposition that we can bring to market together is really, really amazing. You know, our great strength in operations and facilities and workplace, coupled with, you know, Autodesk's position in the market, I think is amazing. And we as a company are very excited about not only the partnership, but the technology and innovation that we continue to work on together.
At present, over 95% of data generated during design and construction is lost or underutilized. And actually, that's a big miss for building owners and operators, because there's potentially kind of really rich asset data that we're simply not using. And there's lots of kind of wasted effort in trying to kind of replicate those asset databases. So I think there is some good synergies with the two companies working together to try to bridge that data gap. Why don't you tell us about the state of the market today? What types of programs are your customers running?
Today is a new world from where we were just 24, 30 months ago prior to the pandemic. We were seeing a lot of trends over the last number of years, particularly around digital transformation, hybrid work, hoteling. These kinds of initiatives were really starting to get momentum, and we were actually right on the pulse of that transition with our products. And overnight, when the pandemic happened and everybody shut their offices and packed up and went home, that really transitioned the whole industry into the way people look at their buildings, the way that they manage the space and how much space they need, the type of space they need, and then the tools that they want to provide to their employees. So when they do come to the office, they can find somebody, they can book a desk, they can get the services that they need to be productive when they are in the office. Very interesting time around the workplace side of things.
One of the stats I've read and found very interesting is that COVID has accelerated digitization by 3 or 4 years. So it's certainly been an interesting time.
Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, I think we were on the journey, but overnight, it's fully here. Hybrid work is here, and I don't think it's going away.
I'd be interested to hear your perspective of what the future of buildings and workplaces looks like.
It's definitely going to continue to evolve. The innovation around digital twins and what that means, and of course it means different things to different people, but I think we're going to see the systems, the software, the solutions predict and recommend based on real world conditions. So whether it's managing occupancy or measuring occupancy and having the building adjust based on the load, cleaning schedules, all of the kind of autonomous things that we really are seeing people wanting to get to. That's not going to happen overnight. I think it's going to follow a similar journey to even BIM when it first came out as a new technology. So it's going to follow an innovation curve or a maturity curve over the next many years. But I think that's where things are going to continue to go. And areas that we're focusing on are things like predictive maintenance, making recommendations, automating a lot of the day-to-day tasks that people have when they want to interact and work with their facilities.
It's very interesting. I mean, for me, the eventual future of buildings will be autonomous buildings.
Yeah.
So they'll be self-thinking, self-optimizing, bringing in real-time data about the assets, but also about people. So they kind of create these great experiences. But I think in the next 3 years, there's still a lot of innovation that we can look forward to. I think we're going to see more data-driven buildings. We're going to see the rise of demand-led services. So everything is kind of starting to be based on kind of more data inputs and more insights. And clearly there's a role for lots of different technologies there, including digital twins. So we've spoken there about the market, how it's changing and where it's going. It'd be interesting now to talk about our strategic alliance.
We are very fortunate to, over the last several years, bring together a lot of great technology from a number of different companies that we've merged over the last few years that deliver solutions for really the whole lifecycle management of a building, everything from where employees are going to sit today, managing occupancy, assets, maintenance, lease management. So we're really excited about all the technology that we've brought together. And now we're on a great journey along with Autodesk to take that technology, build it into a platform that we can then continue our integration with Autodesk and deliver an integrated solution that covers all of the needs for the full building lifecycle management. What is interesting, and I think you touched upon it, is there is a lot of other handoffs that happen throughout the process, from planning to design, from design to engineering, from engineering to construction, and so on, that there are lots of losses of information at each one of those handoffs. And I think what the work that Autodesk is doing to connect that and smooth that through all of the collaboration tools that you're bringing to market, that the data at the end of the process when people are starting to get into operations is already so much more rich than it used to be or could have been. The systems are more interoperable, and we're working together, of course, to make that transition into the operations workflows and data management that we do in our solutions even, you know, as easy as possible and as robust as possible, and providing tools to validate that the deliverables coming through that process.
With the alliance, Nick, I'd love to hear your perspective on how customers will benefit from this.
You know, obviously, just benefit from being more productive. Whether it's like we were talking about around data loss and transitioning to day one operations ready for a new facility, or just optimizing their existing facilities with better data, better automation, better integration and visualizations that our combined solutions can bring. And really helping them through this transition that the whole market's going through from prior to the pandemic to now, and what the facilities and their spaces and buildings mean to their organizations and their employers. As we know, facilities are typically the second largest expense in most organizations, and they're looking at those hard now. So if we can help with data and tools to optimize, I think that would be really, really great. What are you guys seeing around this in terms of how, from your perspective, this is going to benefit your customers?
From our perspective, I think one of the major factors is going to be enabling Autodesk to have a full life cycle proposition for buildings. And this will bring two major benefits. So firstly, it will be an opportunity for firms that have already invested in BIM or CAD to get value from these investments for longer. So they're no longer kind of tools simply for kind of design and construction. Actually, something like BIM can now be the kind of backbone for managing buildings throughout their life cycle. And secondly, we work a lot with building owners, and we have done for many years. But actually, in terms of success, I think part of it is delighting existing customers. So we work a lot with building owners. So imagine firms kind of owning and operating airports, hotels, shopping malls, etc. And we think by working with Eptura, we'll have a really strong life cycle proposition. And then actually, if we look into the future, I think it's really interesting if Autodesk has a play in the space of operations, because we've spoken about closing the loop. So I think in the future, there's a potential for us to kind of support the industry with feeding back this operational data into new projects, whether it's new buildings or kind of renovations and retrofits. At the same time, we know that the built environment has been one of the slowest asset classes to digitize. So I'd be interested in your views around what is holding the industry back.
I think there's a lot of things that come into play around, the slowness or resistance to change. A lot of it's just legacy. This is the way we've always done it. I think our biggest competitor is to do nothing, use Excel and other tools. So that's number one. Obviously, there's cost and time, as in the perception that it is expensive and time consuming, where it doesn't really need to be that way. There's a lot of value that can be derived from a very simple implementation to tackle a specific challenge that the organization might have, and then they can add to that over time. You don't have to boil the ocean all at once. You can do things little by little. And I think so there's a education that needs to happen to get people to understand that it's not a all at once. You can do it as a journey. And the other thing I think is that people are just not sure where to start. By breaking it down and making sure that the owners can understand what they want to get out of it, then we can work together to kind of break it down into the pieces that they need and make sure that they're asking the right questions, that their vendors are asking the right questions and providing the right information. Those are the things that tend to kind of hold back, I think.
Yeah, it's interesting. And just some further things I have observed in my own work is actually, sometimes corporate real estate managers can be quite risk adverse. They don't want to be the ones implementing a kind of shiny new technology that ends up kind of causing kind of new chaos to the workplace. So I've seen a bit of that, and I think that mindset of let's keep doing it how it's always been done. And actually, sometimes the way that facility managers access budgets can be quite challenging. Sometimes the budgets across an organization for facilities technology projects can be quite fragmented. So you're trying to access kind of a very localized budget rather than one that's kind of centrally managed, which would typically fund more IT transformational programs. So yeah, there's lots of barriers there. At the same time, I think the point we've been talking about a lot recently is about going on a journey. It's okay to start small with the technology projects and build up from there.
Have you found some industries versus other are either more apt to go down the path or more resistant to taking the plunge into this journey?
Yeah, we have seen some quite different trends by industry. And actually another big variance in the market is whether a building occupier owns the building or leases a building. So you will often find healthcare, education, because they're long-term building owners, they're more incentivized to invest in these technology projects that might pay off across many years. While someone leasing a building may be more reluctant to make a transformational investment in their building. But there's some really exciting at the same time projects happening, even in the workplace at the moment. Hybrid working is kind of forcing us to rethink how offices are designed, how they're managed, to be experiences. So that's one sector that I think that's really changed in recent years with new appetites for technology innovation.
We've seen a little bit of a pivot recently of keyword searches that people, we track that stuff. And what people are searching on, it was a lot of around hybrid work, return to office. Those were kind of key terms that people were searching on. And recently we've seen renovation move up the scale lately, which is, we think is great, because I think that means that we're getting into the next phase of this hybrid journey, post-pandemic world. And now people are, I think, gonna be creating new spaces, new types of spaces, and you know, the technology enabling those spaces is gonna be, I think, really key for both of us to offer really great value to those customers.
Thank you very much for joining us today. Certainly the big takeaway for me is that we're looking to be stronger together and offer a full building lifecycle solution. It'll be great to hear your kind of closing conclusion.
I think we're really just at the beginning, and really looking forward to where this is going to go for both of our organizations and the really great innovative things that I think we can do together. And really enjoyed the conversation today. Thank you for having me, and look forward to continuing to work together.